And the other two jobs, the library and the law firm, that's from another type of program.
Yeah, is that from Workplace Incorporated?
Yes, that's in Ansonia, Connecticut.
Okay. And what is that? Is it a school?
It's sort of a school. At first, you start off training a little bit in the first week, and then that's when, at the end of the week, they tell you what job to go do, and based on your interests and your skills, and you work for a couple of weeks, and you get paid a more unique type of way than the other jobs, more higher than that.
So the Workplace Incorporated really is more so strictly focusing on putting people with autism in the workplace and giving them experience and training them.
Yes.
Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Okay.
That's right.
And then the deli and Kohl's and the pet spa, that's through High Road.
Yes.
So do they do that throughout high school, or is that in the 12-plus program?
That's during the 12-plus program.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you'll be going to school, and then part of school will be working at these places.
Yes, that's
okay.
Right.
Okay. So at the deli, we already know that you were Elvis.
Yes.
You worked for prepping stuff in the back and that sort of thing. What did you do at the pet spa?
Pet spa, before there was actually two different types of pet places. There was the pet spa, where we had basically just clean up the places after the mess of the dogs. Just basically clean up the fur and mop the floors and sleep in a little bit and clean dishes. And there was another place called the Puppy Playground that's in Wallingford as well, which is actually far off of where it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually where another Vinny's place is called Vinny's Garden Center.
Yeah.
Yep. And we just basically play with the dogs and clean up after them and play with them. And
okay. And at Kohl's, you what was your job there?
We actually organized the different clothes and other items in a matter of order.
Okay.
Yeah.
So all very realistic jobs. What do you think you've learned most from working at those jobs? Is that a tough one?
Yeah, it's quite sort of tough.
I mean, does it teach you responsibility?
Yep.
Does it teach you?
Yeah. Yeah. Teach me a lot more. Teach me a lot more about the responsibilities of the jobs. You have to be a more mature level. You can't be so silly in the job. You gotta make sure your taxes done and yes,
that's exactly it. So it's really taught you. It's having that experience has taught you more than you could learn in a classroom, right?
Yeah. Basically, when you're out of job, and basically when you're home too, because you're actually. Like at Kohl's, I had to fold the clothes in a clean way, and which basically helped me with my laundry too.
Mm-hmm. That's good point. Good point. Your mom likes that, right?
Yes.
So we talked a lot about your interests, your likes, but you also have some dislikes.
Yes.
Right. We've talked about your dislike of crowds.
Yeah.
Not liking crowds.
Yeah.
Bugs.
Yeah.
Hot temperatures, that kind of thing. Why are these dislikes of yours? I mean, do they give you anxiety? I mean, why are they dislikes of yours?
Because, well, basically my skin can't really handle that kind of temperatures. Whether it's too hot or too cold outside, I don't think my skin can really handle that much because my skin's very sensitive.
Mm-hmm. And being in big crowds and being outside, that kind of thing, does it give you anxiety?
Yeah, most of the time.
Some of those dislikes are because of your autism, you think?
Yeah, but I have good medication that'll take care of me. Whenever I get too anxious and they want me to calm down, that's what basically they do for me.
What have you found helps you when you're in a time of anxiety or a time of nervousness without medicine? What helps you to get back to a point where you are calm again?
When there's sometimes when I need some time by myself, when I need like a drink of water or want to go for a walk or take a step outside, that's when I like to cool down a little bit.
And it's good that you know that. You know, maybe when you first in seventh grade, maybe you needed someone to help you with that, right?
Yes.
But now you're able to do that on your own.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm most interested about your movies. I've heard you have quite the collection.
Yes.
And I've heard that you have a special way of organizing them. So tell us about your movies, your movie collection.
What I usually do is organize them by their movie productions, and I also alphabetize them by their by when they came in.
The year they were released?
Yes.
And you organize them by the production company?
Yes.
By alphabetical order?
Yeah, like Disney, 20th Century Fox, Warner Brothers, all that.
That's impressive. And how many, what's a guess, how many movies do you have?
I'd say, I think I remember it was over 410.
Wow.
Yeah.
But that's a big passion of yours. You enjoy them, right?
Yes, I try not to rub it in, though.
So on a more serious note, what, how has ASRC helped you?
They definitely are quite good people here. They are, because they understand a lot of our needs and what they need us to improve with, and I have great privilege working here at Cox Cable here too, because it develops my experience over the tech group of how the TV works, TV and movies and all that.
Which is a big love of yours.
Yes.
Yeah. How would you describe, or what would you say to someone who is autistic and they're not with ASRC and they really, you know, should probably be with a program like that? What would you say to encourage them to come? What could you say to encourage someone who has autism to come to ASRC?
What I'd say is if you put your mind to it, you can accomplish anything, because,
It's all in the head, right?
Yep, it's all in the head. Because as I said, if you put your mind to it, you can accomplish anything. And look at me now.
And would you consider that the number one lesson you've learned through ASRC?
Yeah, and don't get stressed out, because you gotta have the utmost confidence in yourself and others too.
Yeah. Very good. Well, I want to thank you. Thank you so much for being with us.
It's been great
hearing personally. You know, we've had people talking about autism, but I've never gotten to talk to someone with autism. And it's extremely eye-opening, and I hope everyone at home can learn from this as well. And we suggest everyone to go to the ASRC website, which will be at the bottom of your screen. If you have any questions or any friends, family with autism, make sure to check it out. We really would love to help anyone out who is seeking help. And thank you so much for being here with us today. We want to thank Danny and everyone on our production crew. Thank you so much for being with us. We'll see you next time, everybody. Bye-bye.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You are only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird fly. Blackbird fly. To the line of a dark black night. Blackbird fly. Blackbird fly. To the light of a dark black night.